What is going on, YouTube? Tigers here, back doing another video, and as you can see, I kind of need a shave. Okay, no, but seriously though, today I'll be talking about how I made this future pop, future bass. It's, I guess you can call it future pop drop here, and I'll be going over specifically, mainly the chords and the buildup. Let's go ahead and take a listen to this real fast and see what we're working with here. This is a unreleased song that comes out on June 8th. Of 2020, so in a couple days here, and I'll put a link down in the description below to where you can pre-save this song on Spotify if you like it, or you can just block me, that's cool too, I don't even care anymore. But without further ado, let's just take a listen to this track real fast. We'll just build up and drop. Here we go.
So don't you worry about me, I can carry myself home, cause I got it on my own. So don't you
okay, so like I said, this song comes out on June 8th. It's being released with EDM.com's Wunderlust. And let's get into how I did this, actually. So basically, the main idea is it came up with this chord progression right here. And this was the original idea for the whole track, right? These vocals I found on Splice. They're super cool vocals, completely royalty-free, you know, absolutely free to use. If you ever use Splice, and you know exactly what I'm talking about. I found these really cool vocals and I wanted to build a track around them, so I wrote these chords to them, and this is how the chords sound by themselves. Now, if you're wondering how I did those chords, if I remember this correctly, what I probably did was, okay, I did exactly what I thought I did. So what I did is originally I just wrote some triads, and a triad chord is just a 1-2-3 or a 1-3-5, right? So the root note, the third, and the fifth to make a chord. And what I did, once I have all these chords written, just the triads. I know most future bass, future pop stuff uses sevenths, but instead of using a seventh chord here, I use a triad, and then I duplicate the entire chords up an octave. So I'm getting a repeat of the same chords again, but it just sounds bigger and more full this time. And as you can see, I did not actually add an octave lower down bass note. There's a reason for that too. But here's what they sound. And then without it. So it definitely makes the chord sound a lot bigger and more full. And the reason why I didn't do a bass note in the piano here is because I actually have a separate bass going on for that note specifically. So what I did is I took those chords, you know, dragged them down, duplicated them down here, created that bass note an octave lower, and deleted all the chords, so it's just that lower bass note. I have Facebook blowing up my phone right now. My bass right here actually is a plugin called Ample Bass, and I actually use this for like all of my tracks now. Not for the drops, but for everything except the drop. So all my intros, if I use bass there, my verses, bridge, build up, that kind of stuff, because I like the way this bass sounds. It's just, I mean, it's literally just a bass guitar. You know? And it's really cool, is it's like, it's not your typical sub bass, so it is filling in other extra frequencies that, you know, you wouldn't have to do all the extra work for. And it just sounds really nice, too. The next thing I have going on here is actually the same chords again, but I have a, it's called Ample Guitar, which is another free plugin, just like the, if I didn't mention already, the Ample Bass is a free plugin. Both these are free plugins, if you get the light. Alright, make sure you get the light, otherwise it costs. I'm not sure how much it costs, but I don't really do much with this plugin. I think on this one all I did was just throw some EQ on to cut out some of the lows, and I'm pretty sure I didn't even touch it from there. I mean, there's still things you can do on here. There's a couple different parameters you can mess around with, and I haven't really figured it out too much. I know there's a way you can like change the strumming pattern and stuff on some of these, and especially when you can click over here and change these around and stuff. But it's a little confusing to me. I haven't really played around too much with it, but I like the way it sounds just by itself, so. Thank you. As you can hear, I did kind of cut the chords again on the four. Well, so it's playing an extra note again before, or an extra chord again before the next chord hits. So let's hear what the chords are here. It's actually just this whole section. Cool. Okay, so also what I did is the lead that I used in my drop here, which is this sound. Duplicated onto a different track over here, kind of stretched the notes out a little more, you know, elongated them, and then I threw a different plugin on. I'm using another guitar plugin here, but this one's different. This is actually from Expand. If you saw my last video on how to make the best trap lead, this is also the same plugin, Expand. Then I use the hard steel string guitar. So if you go on guitars here, you'll find it in here somewhere. I'm not gonna go look for, okay, never mind. I think I found it right here. Hard steel string guitar. That's all it is. I just used that. I threw some delay on there. I threw some reverb on. If you want to see my reverb chain, that's it right there. Some Valhalla room. Okay, and this is what it sounds like by itself. And I did add a filter, so this filtering up. As you can see there, there's a high pass filter. It's going from low to high pass. And I like doing stuff like that because it's not, you're not giving away like the main sound of the actual lead in the drop. You're building into it, so they're hearing it. So as you can see, you're hearing this sound, but you're not hearing like the full big, bright, you know, almost big room house style lead. Okay, so the drop is actually really, really simple. What I did is I actually just followed the same exact chord pattern as I've been using the whole time, right here. So this is the same, these are all the same pattern, even in the same order, like the changes right here, the next chord there, this next chord again, you know, and so on and so on. But what I did this time is I just cut the chords up a little bit, you know, put in spaces there, and just threw in different spots. And I believe if I did what I normally do on this kind of music, a lot of my chords probably follow the kick pattern. Yeah, so as you can see, my kick up here, this ah kick thing, I actually put the chord on each kick. So whenever a kick plays, I have the chord playing, which is a pretty cool rhythmic thing you can do. I like to do that sometimes just because with the way I have my side chaining going on, it's the chords are going to stay at a specific value that I set due to the side chain. So it's not going to go with anything crazy. And the only thing I really got to worry about is just my my lead, because there are other things just playing not at the same time as the kick. You know, they're going to play all over the place. Same with my sub. The sub just follows the same thing as the kick pattern as well. And it's just copying these same bass lines from the chords here. So let's get into these chords. Okay, so I got a couple different layers going on here. First, this layer right here, this is it's a chord preset I made a long time ago for a song I did called Midnight Air. And to this day, that song is still my biggest stream song on Spotify. And it came out in like 2018, I think it was. Yeah, I mean, almost 2019, but it's getting a little dated for me now, I guess, because music goes pretty fast. But I'm not going to recreate this chord for you guys. I actually have my Midnight Air chords and a couple other presets I've made in a sample pack. And I'll leave a link down in the description below for my sample pack. All right, these are all, it's free samples and free presets I've made. You know, it's completely free. So I'll leave that down below. You guys can have at that. This chord, I don't know where I got this from. Is this a preset I found? It might be. Okay, so I'll just leave this one open for you guys to kind of copy if you, this is something you want to copy. So 3, 2, 1, change to effects layer, 3, 2, 1, scrolling down. All right, matrix, if you guys want to look at that one. Global, probably nothing changed over here. And then just real quick, I'm gonna click through these different things here, just so you can see them. LFO 1, LFO 3, the formant. I guess you can't really see these, can you? Okay, well, that's that that preset, and here's what that sounds like by itself. So very squarish. Next one, Holy Grail chords. This chord is actually from the Cymatics feature bass preset pack, and this is the Holy Grail 2. I couldn't tell you if I changed these or not. A lot of times I'll go into presets and I'll tweak them to my own liking. But I don't know if I changed anything on here because I made this song a little while ago and it's kind of hard to remember what I did at this point. But I'll go ahead and leave this up for you as well if you want to copy these settings down. So LFO-1, LFO-2, and the effects layer. Okay, now this last one is the Virtual Riot Dirt Saw. This saw is pretty cool. This is from his Virtual Riot Serum Presets Volume 1, Dirt Saw. Really cool saw sound. I like it a lot. I use it for a lot of stuff, especially when it comes to chord layers. I use stack it up all the time. Now, for the rest of this, EQ completely first, right? When I did, EQ'd out the lows, boost a little bit of the low mids, and boost a little bit of the highs. All right, add a standard sidechain with the BitWig built-in dynamics, you know, the sidechain to my kick. Ratio up to 1.82. Attack all the way down, release all the way down, and I had my threshold down to -36.3. OTT, didn't do much here, just turned the depth up to, that's about 12, 13-ish. 8% there. And the last thing is, again, my favorite thing in the world, some reverb sidechaining. Checked out that video, guys. I'll put a link for that one in the description below. I'm not going to explain this one this time. I've explained it in almost all my videos now. If you watch my videos, you'll know what reverb sidechaining is. I use it all the time. Drums in this style of music is, like the future pop stuff, is kind of important because you don't want to overdo it. You know, if you got too much going on, too much, you know, heavy hitting, hard hitting stuff, it's just not going to sound as good. Take it easy on your drums, okay? Use, like, simpler samples, and just make sure when you do your mix, your drums are poking out really well. They're really punchy, you know, and snappy. Here's what my drums sound like on their own. And I didn't do anything crazy with my drums. You know, there's no effects on my actual group layer there. My kick, I put a little bit of a high pass in there, like at 20 hertz, nothing special. A little bit of reverb on my snares there, it's a little reverb sidechain on this clap. Just a simple crash from Cymatics. A tambourine sound. Tambourine sounds, I didn't want to use a hi-hat, because I think hi-hats just sound a little too easy, you know? I used it in the second half of the drop, but the tambourines, it's cool because it keeps a good rhythm going. So, you know, it's like a dynamic thing. It's like, you know, it's not always like how hi-hats are. So my leads are a Spire preset. I'm going to keep a secret. I don't want to show you guys that one. You can hear what that sounds like. And these notes are as follows, if you want to see the notes there. I didn't use crazy high notes. Kind of surprising. I know a lot of people for leads they'll use like the C3 to C4 register, but I didn't use that for this one. And then for the layer for it is another expand. And I will go into the expand here. The expand, I did quite a few different things, as you can see, because on expand you can layer your sounds. So I used the guitar Dirty 56 Strat, turned the level down quite a bit on that one. I used the Octave Kalimba Plus on the mallets and the Bright Bells in the bell section, and that's what. That's what they sound like together. And I cut the volume down on that pretty much a lot lower than the Spire sound. Just think of it like a little bright, crystalline sounding layer on top of it. You can hear it's just kind of very punching through the high ends of that sound, because most of the sound is coming from the Spire here. So One more time, I'll play this build up and drop for you guys. Like I said, the song comes out on June 8th, 2020. If you're watching this from the future after songs are released, what's up? I hope you guys pre-save the song on Spotify. I'll leave a link down below for pre-save. Let's go ahead and listen to this one more time, and that is how I did my future pop Don't Worry About Me song.
So don't you worry about me. I can't carry myself home, cause I got it on my own. So don't you worry about me. I won't let you take me home. Leave your number on my phone. Don't worry about me.
Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.